Hello, researchers. Starting with 3041, we've published an experimental Cinema 4D plugin build, so you can look at the new revamped render settings. There are also a few other things in Cinema 4D, but in this video, I'm going to discuss just the render settings changes. And these render settings will be valid for all the DCCs in the near future. Okay, for now, it's just an experimental build to iron things out. But after that, this will be the de facto standard. So let's see what do we have. Now I have here 3041 with S22, and on my right, R23 with 3041, but the experimental build. So I'm gonna start with the new settings in both of them. Let's call this old, let's call this new. And I want to do this from scratch, so there's no shenanigans. I'm not thinking I've prepared something in advance. So I'm gonna switch the redshift in both of these. Okay, so you can see clearly that before we had all of these 9 tabs. Now it's a bit easier. We have basically 2 tabs, basic and advanced, and the advanced, well, has only 8. Okay, it's still 9 in total, but it's way better organized. Let me show you why. First, we're starting with bucket quality. These are presets. And to be honest, the basic settings here, it's pretty much everything you need to get your redshift started. You also have global animation enabled by default, and now it's a simple checkbox. It's on and off, way better than before when you had to go through a list and change from none to one of the primary and secondary render engines, okay, GI engines. So these actually simply set a threshold. This is called threshold, but it's basically the adaptive error threshold. And because we have automatic sampling by default enabled, it's visible in the advanced section, automatic sampling. All you need to do is hit render and you're gonna get medium quality in no time. Everything works, okay? You have GI enabled, it's just nice. What do you need more? You need denoising, you enable denoising. Bam, 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 that's all you need to do. It's a simple checkbox. Instead of going from none, altos, blah, 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 and remember this, right? This is way more visible. I know which engine I'm using because it's visible as a button. It don't have to read it through a list. Motion blur. If you need motion blur, you enable. You need more steps. You just drag the slider, and you have more steps. Do you need deformation blur? You enable deformation blur. These all these settings here in the basic are also in advanced. Okay, I'm gonna show you in a second. You need global animation, just enable it, okay? It will be by default brute force IPC. If you change that in the advanced section, global animation from brute force IPC, you're gonna notice that the basic states here in this little texting, from advanced settings, we've changed the global animation secondary engine, just so you know, okay? It doesn't mean you do this, you're gonna switch the global animation to brute force IPC. No, it's just you're gonna use the exact same things with this kind of override font. Do you need caustics? It's enabled by default. The maximum number of bottoms is enabled by default. It's a default value of 200, okay? Before this was called maximum numbers of caustics photons. Now it's just simply called max photons, okay? And you don't need much else. If you need your, but you can have this enabled anyway, because if you don't have a caustics caster, you're not gonna have any caustics anyway. So that's just simple, okay? Now the biggest change is this threshold slider. You can see here we're at the half of it, right? And it's at 0.01. Before we had just this small range. It's really, really small. And actually you had to go through this to this spinner to actually get this value to change. And luckily this is C4D, but in other DCCs it's not that easy, right? You had to either type it or trying to move the mouse very, very little. Now it's really easy. And you can see this is also going through the presets, right? Now, one thing you're gonna notice is that, for instance, I have this as 0.02 and I can drag it like this, it doesn't change. Now, this is because Cinema 4D is limited in the UI to 3 digits. It doesn't mean that this value, it's not changing. And to be honest, I can show you the same value in the advanced section. Okay, you can see here, I can move it in here, 004. Okay, and if you're going to basic, it will be 004. It's the exact same slider, right? So let's go to 002 here, right? And if I drag this into the console, you can see that I get what value? I get 00245, right? And then I can drag it more. It's still 002 for you, right? I drag it all the way, but it's a different value. Unfortunately, this is just a C4D limitation. Probably this won't be something that will affect other DCCs. But remember, yes, it's 00 something between 001, 0001 and 0003. So it's somewhere there, okay? It's nothing, something we can do. This has to be changed by Maxon. And this probably means a huge change in the UI. You have show samples here, which was before, again, show samples. And just going back to basic, that's all you need to know to do if you're we're punching some differences from the defaults. You're gonna see them in this list. In this case, we've changed the secondary engine for the GI. Okay, so advanced sampling. Well, things are much easier. Sampling, you have unified sampling and progressive rendering. You know what? It's simple. Force enabled for IPR, interactive rendering, progressive or bucket, as simple as that. Bucket means disable this, okay? That's all. Final render, if you want to do it progressive, you can do it progressive. It's the equivalent of enabling progressive here, as simple as that. Again, this is the same thing. Threshold with this called show samples, random noise pattern. Before it was called randomizing pattern every frame. Well, random noise pattern, it's simple. Things are simpler in naming and in location, filtering as before, okay? Denoising is the same thing as denoising before, it's just that you have an enable switch, way handier, and all controls. Texture sampling, because this is sampling related, instead of being in the optimization, it's now in the sampling, makes more sense. Motion blur, well, the same thing as before, it's just the UI for motion blur, it's way, way more visible. Let me show you this. Okay, see, you had to read all this. Remember, center on frame. Well, I don't have to remember, center is the middle of this. It's just as simple as that. Deformation steps, I don't want to go through all this list. I have some values here I can remember. I don't necessarily have to read it. I mean, your interface might be in a different language, right? And if it's Asian language, this is 2, 3, 5, 9, 17, right? And well, of course, this is still a redshift, but it might happen that in the future we'll have pieces of 3 might be written in Chinese, and you know what? I don't have to remember it. Muscle memory says that, well, the same position of this into this list of toggles is that, okay? Globals, well, now the globals incorporates a bit of few things. It incorporates the optimizations tab that we had before with trace depths, okay, with the global overrides, and also the hair. Now, hair was in two parts here. We have hair mean pixel width, and we had system hair tessellation here. It's in one place. You don't have to look for things in two different places. Everything is streamlined, and everything makes a bit more sense. For instance, experimental option, enable optics RT on supported GPUs. Well, what's that? Well, it's simply hardware ray tracing, if available. And it's not called RTX because you might have a different card than an NVIDIA card. Okay, no need to localize that to RTX, it's just harder ray tracing if available. 8-bit quantization and dithering, it was down to the basic, quantize to 8-bit and dither. Okay, camera space rendering from the experimental options, made sense to have it here in the globals. Freeze tessellation, same thing. Okay, default environment, before it was environment material, or just default environment. Trace depths are clear. The global overrides, which were on the optimizations, now have a bit of better names. There's no need to enable reflection, enable reflection. This is visible. Reflections are enabled or disabled. As simple, no need to enable reflections, yes. This makes more sense from the programming point of view, right? This makes more sense from the artistic and user point of view. Next, global animation. Big change here. We've removed photon mapping. Nobody needs it. Okay? And this is actually easier to read from the point of view of settings. You can see here, custom, low, medium, high are now just buttons, no more pull down menus and homeless. Caustics, which before was called photon. Okay, we've removed the photon mapping GI because we're not using it anymore, and we've changed two things. Max numbers of caustics photon is not called photons, which in basic it's called max photons, same thing. And the caustic surge radius is called blur. Okay, why? Well, this makes sense from the programming point of view. You're searching for a number of up to 200 caustics photons in a radius of 0.1. Visually, it's blurring the caustics. As simple as that. Okay, same thing, fast irradiance, trace depth, blah, blah. AOVs, we don't have to carry about quick add an AOV and manually do the old ways. We have the show AOV manager, which is a fantastic tool. Best one I've seen so far. Okay, everything else works and it's easier to read. Again, it's just easier. You don't have lists, you have toggle buttons. Simple. Optimizations. Okay, now optimizations is not exactly the same thing that we had before. You have in the optimizations, you have the SSS, which was on its own here. And you have the threshold, the cutoff threshold, the Russian roulette, and the ray tracing acceleration, which was on the system side. Okay, everything in one place. Everything is easier to read. System. Now we've integrated memory integration and a few other things into the system. Now the system, it's a bit longer, but you know what? You don't have to read it. Okay. It's a combo of different things. Logs and feedback, now it's one place, not feedback display, not log display, it's log and feedback, one thing. Bucket rendering, it's come down from here up, and you know what, it's easier to read. Look at this, three options, great. Okay, bucket order, simple. Shader baking, which was in the integration tab, now it's simply texture width, texture height, texture depth for C4D shader baking, okay, and the sky width, so forth, so forth. Freeze, if you want to freeze your scene update, okay. Units, makes sense, it was here, but it was also basic photometric units. Oh, why two places? We have one place now, okay. Legacy, it's a bit longer because it integrates options from both experimental and legacy. In the same place, you have lens effect camera, which before was on a basic and it was lens effects. Okay, this is a global lens effects for old cameras in the scene that don't have a specific reshift camera tag, okay, or reshift parameters enabled. It's gone into the legacy. The same thing for material override. Why? Because the material override now we support material override effect, which can override a specific material with a specific material, or a group of specific materials with one material. This is really, really nice. Before, the material override, which is actually called clay mode in IPR, which was a toggle, was just a Lambertian diffuser runner. Okay, now it can be whatever you want to be. Okay, you drag a custom material here and you include or exclude materials that you want to overwrite, and that's it. It's really, really nice. That's why it is got into the material override, into the legacy. Okay, use combine tray, blah, blah, blah. All of these, okay, all of these from here are here, and they make more sense. They're a bit easier to remember for an artist. You don't say enable legacy volume grid emission, so it's for by default is disabled. This, so it's like I'm disabling the enable legacy. No, simply legacy volume grid emission, it's enabled by default or not, you know. That's as simple as this. You see here enable disable disappear from the actual name, and everything makes a bit more sense. This again is makes sense from a programming point of view. This makes more sense from an artist point of view. Okay, debug capture, same thing as before, right? And memory, which had its own tag tab, it's now here. That's all there is to Xlogs. It's really simple. We hope you're gonna enjoy it. We've really put a lot of effort in deciding where things go and how they behave. I think it's absolutely fantastic, and I hope you will enjoy it as well. As always, happy rest of the day. Cheers.